Ladies and gentlemen, may we all rise in honor of the bride. This is a very special occasion in joining Kelly and Anthony in the union of marriage. Sir, and who gives this bride to be?
Her father, Hugo Rodriguez.
Thank you, sir. Anthony, you may receive your bride. Now, the two of you have each had separate paths that led you to this very moment. And that's what the unity candle will represent later on in the ceremony, how your two individual lives will now become one through marriage. Thank you, you may be seated. Now, Anthony and Kelly, if there's a few things that I hope would carry along its way with the two of you throughout your journey together, it would be for you both to always be willing, from the heart, to listen, learn, and to love. And by that I simply mean to always be willing to listen to one another, what it is that they have to offer, and what makes them feel whole, complete, and part of this relationship. Because after all, they just may be the voice of reason. And secondly, is the ability to learn. Always be willing to learn whatever it takes to help the other fulfill every desire, every wish, every dream, and goal that they may have. And lastly, most important is the ability to love one another unconditionally, which means no strings attached. It's an ongoing love. And this is the type of love that I hope the two of you would wish to express to one another each and every day. Keeping in mind, Anthony, that Kelly's happiness will always be far more important than your own. And also that Anthony's happiness will be more important than yours. And the reason for that is, with that in your minds and in your hearts, I have no doubt that your lives together will be everything that you want it to be. So with that said, sir, I'll ask you first. With your presence here today, alongside Kelly, do you take her as your wife and promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting her always, allowing nothing or no one to ever come between the two of you? Do you take her as your wife, sir?
I do.
Kelly, I'll ask you the same. With your presence here today, alongside Anthony, do you take him as your husband and promising to love, honor, cherish, and respecting him always, allowing nothing or no one to ever come between the two of you? Do you take him as your husband?
I do.
And if I could have you hand over your bouquet. And I'll have the two of you turn and face each other and hold each other's hands, please. As you look into each other's eyes, you will see the very reason of what brought you here this evening, proving that at this moment, there is no one more important than who stands. So, Anthony, as you look into her eyes, I'll have you repeat your vows. I, Anthony, take you, Kelly.
I, Anthony, take you, Kelly.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I will always be there for you.
I will always be there for you.
Through the good times and the bad.
Through the good times and the bad.
Whether we are rich or poor.
Whether we are rich or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Through laughter and tears.
Through laughter and tears.
I will love and cherish you.
I will love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge.
I give you my pledge.
Thank you. And if there's anything else you'd like to say?
Met you 2 years ago, Kelly. 2.5. It's been a wild ride. It really has. But regardless of anything that happened and anything that went down, I'm still standing here in love with you as I will be for the rest of my entire life.
Thank you, sir. Kelly?
Thank you.
Now, as you look into Anthony's eyes, I have you repeat your vows. I, Kelly, take you, Anthony.
I, Kelly, take you, Anthony.
To be my husband.
Be my husband.
I will always stand beside you.
Will always stand beside you.
Through success and misfortune.
Through success and misfortune.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
Through the joys and sorrows of life.
And in health.
In sickness and in health.
Through laughter and tears.
And through laughter and tears.
I will love and cherish you.
I will love and cherish you.
I give you my pledge.
Thank you.
And if there is anything you would like to add.
I love you. That's all I can say.
Okay. And at this time, may I have the rings, please? We got one down. Perfect. Well, these rings will seal this commitment. And they're not only tokens, but symbols of the very love and devotion that the two of you are expressing here today. And my hope is that in each and every day with the two of you wearing these rings, may they constantly remind you of that promise and pledge that you have just made to one another. And in time, the rings themselves may lose beauty, but I hope that the two of you would not only value, but take honor in wearing these rings for what they truly represent. And through your friends and family, the beauty will shine through you both. And the two of you will always remain a wonderful example to all. So Anthony, as you take her ring, as you place it upon her ring finger, if you would please repeat, with this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise.
I seal my promise.
To be your faithful and loving husband.
Your faithful and loving husband.
And I am so honored.
And I am so honored.
To call you my wife.
To call you my wife.
Okay. As you place it upon his ring finger, if you would please repeat, with this ring.
With this ring.
I seal my promise. To be your faithful and loving wife.
To be your faithful and loving wife.
And I am so honored.
And I am so honored.
To call you my husband.
Thank you.
Now at this time, if I could have the two of you step over to the unity candle. As I mentioned earlier, the two of you have each had separate paths that led you to this very point. And it's the individually lit tapers that are representing your individual lives. And in life, you will not only be uniting yourselves, but that of your families as well. So I ask the two of you can take a hold of your individual taper, if you could light the center candle at the same time. which is also symbolizing the creation of a new journey with new memories. Once lit, if I could have the two of you turn and blow out your individual taper. And I'll invite the two of you back in front of the podium. Oh, Kelly and Anthony. If you love someone, you'll be loyal to them no matter what the cost. You will always stand beside them. You will always love and trust them. And you will stand your ground in defending them no matter what. Now, there's a poem I'd like to share with the two of you. And it is in part. And it says, I love you, not only for who you are, but for who I am when I am with you. I love you for taking your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all of those weak or frivolous things you can't help but see there, but drawing out all of the good and the beautiful and the radiant things that dwell within. Now I know the future may hold some ups and downs, but if the two of you would always remember to look back at all the moments, all the memories, and all the very reasons that brought the two of you here today. Like I mentioned earlier, I have no doubt that your lives together will be everything that you want it to be. So it certainly has been a joy to be part of the celebration with you both. And the 12th of December, a day that will now mark your anniversary. In the presence of friends and family, as witnesses, the two of you have each showed your intentions by the exchanging of your vows and the exchanging of your rings. Therefore, with the authority vested in me by the state of Nevada, it is my honor and my privilege to now be able to pronounce you as husband and wife. Anthony, you may now kiss your wife, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, they will now have their first dance.
I will still away.
supposed to ask about the song?
On the TV, turn and face your guests. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Pricer, the newlyweds. Congratulations. Now walk your wife down the aisle.